लास्ट टॉपिक इंटरपोलेशन एंड एक्सट्रापोलेशन. इंटरपोलेशन एक्सट्रापोलेशन नथिंग बट टेक्निक ऑफ एस्टिमेटिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल फॉर एनी इंटरमीडिएट वैल्यू ऑफ द इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल इज कॉल्ड एज इंटरपोलेशन. सेम डेफिनेशन फॉर एक्सट्रापोलेशन, दैट एस्टिमेटिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल फॉर एनी वैल्यू ऑफ द इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल विच इज आउटसाइड द रेंज ऑफ द गिवन सीरीज विदइन द लिमिट इज कॉल्ड एज इंटरपोलेशन. Beyond the limits is called as extrapolation. Some assumptions and methods are there. For that they are given the modes. For two methods in our syllabus, binomial expansion method and Newton's method. In the binomial expansion method, if any one of the y values, this is x and this is y values, any one of the y values missing, then we go through binomial expansion method. Otherwise, we go through Newton's method. In the problem here, they are given 2 to 2 years gap, 95, 97, 99, 97, 23. There is no sudden jump in the values of series of observations. And the production, we have one missing value. Then we go through interpolation technique by the method of binomial expansion method. Here, yx, x takes the value zeros in the suffix, y0, y1, y2, y3, y4. Here, how many known figures means? It is 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 known values are there. Therefore, we have the equation y minus 1 to the power of equals to 0 as in the a minus b to the power of 2, a plus b over to the power of 2. This expansion, we get this format according to binomial expansion method. Write the equation such a way that it is y4, y3, y2, y1, y0 is equals to 0. We have one more, y minus 1 to the power of 0. Write in this way, y4, y3, y2, y1, y0 equals to 0. And take the sign opposite, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus. First plus, minus, plus, minus, plus. First one, last one, n equals to 4, before that one is 4, here n is 4. Next one is, take one less than that number, 4 into 3 divided by 2 into 1, we get a 6. That is a NCR formula, n factorial divided by n minus r factorial into r factorial. Otherwise, here 4 is there, next one is 3, 4 into 3 divided by 2 numbers are there, 2 into 1. If it is 3, 4 into 3 into 2 divided by 3 into 2 into 1, we get a 4. But here already we get 4 value by binomial is always symmetrical. First is 1, last is 1, next is n equals to 4, here 4, and here we get 4. For next number, 4 into 3 divided by 2 into 1. Suppose if n value is 5, known values, y minus 1 equals to 0, y5, y4, y3, y2, y1, y0 is equals to 0. First, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus. First one, last one. Next is n equals to 5, here 5. 5 into next number is 4, divided by 2 into 1, we get 10, here also 10. We get 1, 5, 10, 10, 5, 1, that is symmetrical in case of binomial. Suppose if it is known values are 6, y minus 1 to the power of 6 equals to 0, y6, y5, y4, y3, y2, y1, y0 is equals to 0. Plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus. First one, last one. N equals here 6, 6. Before that number, last one is 6. 6 into 5 divided by 2 into 1. 30 by 2 is 15. Last, the second number is 15. One more we need here. Therefore, 6 into 5 into 4 divided by 3 into 2 into 1. According to NCR formula, we get 3, 2 is a 6, gets cancelled, 4, 5 is a 20. 1, 6, 15, 20. Again reverse, 15, 6, 1. We get the coefficients in the equation. That is due here. Similarly, here y minus 1 to the power of y equals 0. 1, y4, minus 4, y3, plus 6, y2, minus 4, y1, plus 1, y0 equals to 0. Substitute the values. 1 into y4 is 130. Minus 4 into y3 is unknown as it is. Plus 6 into 70, minus 4 into 40, plus 1 into 20 equals to 0. Multiply, 130 is a 130, this as it is 4y3, 670 is a 420, 440 is a 160, 20 ones are 20 equals to 0, always equated to 0. This on simplification we get 410 minus y43 as it is. Bring this right hand side, minus becomes plus. Now 410 equals to 4y3. 410 by 4 we get y3. We get 102.5. Similarly, 5 knowns, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We get y minus 1 to the power of 5. We have the equation 1y5 minus 5y4 plus 10y3 minus 10y2 plus 5y1 minus 1y0 equals to 0. Substitute the values according to the corresponding y values. We get the unknown value y2 here. Similarly, y equals to n. In this way, we find the values for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 known figures are there. Substitute the values for this equation, we get the corresponding values. Here is the y minus 1 to the power of 6 equals to 0, y6, y5, y4, y3, y2, y1, y0, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus. First one, last one, n equals to 6 here. 6 less than 1 is 5, divided by 2 into 1 is 15. Before the second value is 15. Again, we need one more value. 6 into 5 into 4, 3 digits, here 3 is there, divided by 3 into 2 into 1, we get 20. Again, by simplification, we get this one. This is binomial expansion method. Next one. Newton's method. Here no one is missing in the y values, but you have to estimate in between the values. We go through Newton's method. We have the formula yx equals to y naught plus x delta naught 1, x into x minus 1 delta naught 2 divided by 2 factorial, plus x into x minus 1 into x minus 2 delta naught 3 divided by 3 factorial, so on. Where x equals to interpolated value, they are given in the question, minus value at the origin, starting point of the year, difference between the two adjoining values. Delta naught 1, delta naught 2, delta naught 3 are leading differences that will be explained in the problem. Here, the problem is this way. Find the number of persons living in age 25 years. They are given age and number of periods. In age are always equal differences, 20, 30, 40, 50, always 20, 25, 30, 35, so on. Number of persons are given. Here, age and number of persons are given. Yx is taken as y0, y1, y2, y3. Deltas are taken as leading differences. First difference, any value minus preceding value. For example, here, 49 minus 53 gives minus 4. 36 minus 49 gives minus 13. 23 minus 36 gives minus 13. So, in this way we get the results. That is delta naught 1, delta naught, delta 1 at 1, delta 1 at 2. Again, from this, minus 13, minus of minus 4. That is minus 13 plus 4. We get minus 9. Similarly, third value, minus 13, minus of minus 13, second value, minus 13 plus 13 gives 0. That is delta 2 value is 0 and 1. Until continue process, till we get a single value. Now, 0 minus of minus 9, that is 0 plus 9, we get 9. That only one value, stop the table. This carrying 4 marks in the exam, and that is up to y3 we get delta naught 3. If it is y5 we get up to delta naught 5. Now x equals to interpolated value minus value at origin divided by difference. Interpolated value means in the question they are given 25, and origin means starting of the age 20, difference of the values 10. We get 0.5. We have the formula up to delta naught 3. Y naught plus x delta naught 1 plus x into x minus 1 divided by 2 factorial into delta naught 2 plus x into x minus 1 into x minus 2 into delta naught 3 divided by 3 factorial. Delta naught 1 is 53, delta naught is, y naught is 53 plus x is 0.5, delta naught 1 is minus 4, plus 0.5 into 0.5 minus 1 divided by 2 factors 2 into 1. Delta naught 2 is 9 and divided plus 0.5 into 0.5 minus 1, 0.5 minus 2 into 9 divided by 3 into 2 into 1. 53 as it is, multiply these two plus into minus minus 0.5 into 4 is 2. Plus 0.5 as it is, minus 0.5 minus 1 is minus 0.5 into minus 9 divided by 2 as it is. 0.5 minus 0.5 minus 1.5 into 9 divided by 6. On simplification, we get the 52.68 approximately 53%. This is the answer. Sometimes I have given two values. Here the number of students are 492 students. We have written the exam. We find the number of students who have scored between 48 and 52 marks. They are given not more than. Not more than means it is less than. If the not more than they are given, as it is you go through the problem. They are given 210, 250. Both are these two columns are there given. You have to make this column. Y0, Y1, Y2, Y3, Y4, Y5. Here Y5 is there. Ends with delta not 5 in such a way to prepare the table. Here 253 minus 210 is 43. 307 minus 250 is 54. 381 minus 307 is 74. 413 minus 381 is 32. 492 minus 413 is 79. Similarly, 54 minus 43 is 11, 74 minus 54 is 20, 32 minus 74 is minus 42, 17 minus 32 is 47. This is delta naught 2. 20 minus 11 is 9, minus 42, minus 20 gives minus 62. 47 minus of minus 42 gives 47 plus 42, that gives 89, that is delta 3's. Now, minus 62 minus 9 is minus 71. 89 minus of minus 62 gives 89 plus 62, that is 151. Now, last one, 151 minus of minus 71 gives 32. We get the table. X, first here two values are, both are not in the series. Take 48 as it is. 48 first value. Origin is 40, difference is 5. We get 1.6. Substitute, apply the formula up to delta naught 5. Substitute the values. On simplification, we get the result. But here, first 220 as it is. 1.6 into 43. 1.6 into 1.6 minus 1 into 11 divided by 2 into 1. Substitute all the values. But the next step, we take 210 as it is, multiplication as it is, but don't substitute, directly calculate. First simplify this, 1.6 into 0.6 into 11 divided by 2. Similarly, 1.6, 0.6, 1.6 minus 2 is minus 0.4 into 9 divided by 6, so on. 210 as it is, 68.8 as it is, take the sign from this problem, in that case, all are positive, take the sign as positive, that gives 5.28. Here 1 minus is there, plus into minus is minus. On simplification we get the 0.576. Here 3 minus are there, again we get minus. Minus into minus plus, plus into minus is minus. Therefore it is 1.59. Again it is 3 minus, take minus it is. Odd number of minus we get minus sign. Even number of minus, we get the plus sign. On simplification, we get the 279.5. That gives a 280. Similarly, we will find for another number as a 52. Same process. X is 52 minus origin is 40 divided by 5. We get 2.4. Substitute, we get this answer. Finally, we take the number of students scored between 48 and 52 marks is. This first one is a Y48, second one is Y52. Highest value minus lowest value, Y52 minus Y48, that gives 339 minus 280 is equals to 59 students scored the marks between 48 and 52. Okay. In case of Classen throws. One more problem here. Classen throws are given 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50, 50 to 60, 60 to 70. Number of workers are given. In case of Classen throws, first make the less than cumulative frequencies, then go for further calculation. Less than 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70. All are upper limits. 50 as it is. 50 plus 80 gives 130. 130 plus 100 gives 230. 230 plus 75 gives 305. 305 plus 40 gives 345. Plus 25 gives 370. Again, Y0, Y1, Y2, Y3, Y4, Y5. We get the, up to delta not 5, we get the tables. We have the calculations here. First calculation is this one. First column. 130 minus 50. 230 minus 130, 305 minus 230, 345 minus 305, 370 minus 345, here the corresponding values. That is delta 1. Second difference means 100 minus 80 is 20, 70 minus 100 is minus 25, 40 minus 75 is minus 35, 25 minus 40 is minus 15. These are calculated from the calculator itself. But if negatives, we go through the calculation. Minus 25 minus 20 is minus 45. Minus 35, minus of minus 25 means minus 35 plus 25 minus 10. In this way, we get the values. So, we get this table value. Interpolate the value for the given value. Only 1 is there, 35. Minus original is 20, difference is 10, 1.5. Substitute in the formula, we get the solution. Here, 181.19 is there. 181.1 is less than 5. We take 181 workers. In this way, we solve the problem, Lincoln's method. If it is 10 marks, only one estimation. If it is 15 marks, we have two estimations. The chance is more for 10 mark question. Go through the calculations. There is no choice here. We concentrate the problem. Otherwise, you have to write the theory question. This completes your syllabus.